America, the land of opportunity. Come from Africa, I had all these images about what America was gonna be like. Now that I'm finally here, all I know is my friend TT better be on time. Sure enough, he was.
Father, man, America,
man, you're back, man, Junior, come on. What are you doing, man?
It was a real blessing being reunited with TT again. I haven't seen him for years. He was in America going to school, working, got a new car. He's living the life, and I could not wait to join him. Later on that evening, me and TT fellowship as we always did. We caught up, talked about the Word of God, and also just talked about what I could expect here in America. TT was very religious, and I looked up to him for that. He was a little younger than me, but probably a little more mature as well. We decided to thank God for my safe coming to America. We also prayed that my future endeavors and studies be successful and I shall prosper with God's strength. I decided to go to bed a little early that night. I was very excited for my first day in America. So the next day, I went to the central building where all the students hang out. Decide if I can meet new people and see what America has to offer. Then there was this girl. She was just staring at me. Kind of made me a little uncomfortable, so I decided to walk away. I took a seat, and next thing you know, it's like she zoomed in on me. I felt the hairs of the back of my neck stand up, and I felt like her eyes were just piercing on me. She was beautiful, smart, confident young lady. And she came up right up to me and introduced herself. She told me her name was Susan, and asked if I was new around here. I told her I just came from Africa and it was my first time in the States. Then, she's telling me that there was a party tonight. I'd never really been to an American party before and didn't know what to expect. I was kind of nervous. But she was so pretty, she had a way with guys, I just gave in. I said, why not? So I got her phone number, told her I could give her a call later. She had her way with her eyes. She just made me feel all warm inside, and I think I was flirting. This is all new to me, and I guess I was growing up. She gave me a high five, and I told her I'd see her on later that night. Later on that evening, the party was jumping, it was hopping, everyone was dancing, having a good time, and of course people were drinking. I never drank before and never really wanted to, but I wanted to fit in, so I decided to try it. Ugh, it was disgusting. Burned my mouth and tastes horrible. I don't know how people did that for fun. I didn't want to drink anymore, but they just kept on offering me more drinks and couldn't resist. Next thing you know, I had way too much to drink. Then Susan asked me to dance. Normally I was never this confident, but this liquid courage was just flowing through me. Eventually, I got way too crazy. By the end of the night, I was just feeling horrible. My stomach was hurting, my head was spinning. I never wanted to feel like this ever again. I thought too much of myself. Soon, Susan came and checked on me. Told her I was feeling nauseous and sick. She wanted to just make sure I had a ride home. I never wanted to ever drink again. Throughout the semester, I kept on hanging out with Susan, kept on going out, kept on partying, and kept on drinking. I didn't think what I was doing was hurting me, but by the end of the semester, I knew my actions were hurting me more than I thought. One morning, TT came in the room and I had my grades posted on the computer. I was depressed. I was angry. I was disappointed in myself. I failed 3 classes. I've never failed a class before. I can't believe I did this to myself. I couldn't imagine what my mom was and my dad were gonna do to me. TT just kept on telling me, trust in God. Believe in yourself. I can do anything with God's strength. And God will forgive me, and I shall move on and prosper and learn from my mistakes. For the days I loved money more than you. From that day on, I decided to make a change. And that change had to start with me. Susan kept on blowing my phone up, and I just kept on ignoring her. I was over it. I didn't want her friendship anymore. She was just a bad influence on me. Susan kept calling over and over again. Eventually, I decided to pick up her phone call and just be honest with her. I couldn't leave her hanging any much longer. She called to say hi and see how I was doing and wonder why I've been ignoring her. Then, before you know it, she invited me to another party. She wanted to go out and drink, smoke, and have sex. I couldn't do it this time. I learned from my mistakes. The whole semester I was making the wrong decisions, and she had a big part to do with it. I had to be honest with her and tell her that I needed to change for myself, to make myself a better person. She was upset, even angry, but her feelings didn't matter anymore. All that matters is that I do what is right in the sight of God, get good grades, and make my family proud. Eventually, we got off the phone. But I pray that Susan would choose the right path that leads her to eternal life. In life, you just have to let go of the things or people that may hinder you from achieving God's purpose for you in this world. Arise and let Christ lead.